like to introduce Khristine Huskey, who's an adjunct professor at Georgetown University Law Center.
Hi, thanks for coming today. It's really hot, isn't it? But your pain is just for today, and some pain for longer than that. But your pain is just for today. Imagine the pain of the men at Guantanamo for over 10 years. I started representing detainees in March of 2002. That was over 11 years ago. That was when people didn't even know anything about Guantanamo. And what we did know, we were told it was the worst of the worst, and terrorists and people who were captured on the battlefield. But today, 11 years later, we know differently, don't we? We know that 95% of the men at Guantanamo were never accused or never found to have actually committed any hostilities against the United States. 86 men have been cleared for transfer or release. Why are they still there? 100 men, as you know, are on hunger strike. 40 are being force-fed. Senator Feinstein went recently because she was concerned about the hunger strikers. And afterwards, she wrote a letter to Defense Secretary Hagel saying, I'm concerned because the force-feeding policies are out of step with international norms, medical ethics, and the practices of the U.S. Bureau on Prisons. Out of step. What she really meant was that those policies violate Article 3 of the Geneva Conventions, which prohibit humiliating and degrading treatment, and those policies violate the United Nations Convention Against Torture. That's because force-feeding, what is happening to 40 men at Guantanamo, means being strapped into a six-point restraint chair, having tubes shoved down your nose against your will. The tubes go into your stomach, and you get Ensure pumped into you six times or twice a day. That is a form of torture. That is torture. Why are the men at Guantanamo doing this? Why are they doing this? Because they are protesting their indefinite detention. Indefinite detention is another form of torture. My previous organization that I worked for, Physicians for Human Rights, came out with a report in 2011 finding that medical evidence shows the physical and psychological trauma of indefinite detention. Medical evidence shows that the uncertainty of not knowing when you'll ever be released, if ever, if you'll ever have a trial, or if you'll ever see your family again, shows that causes severe damage to your immune and your cardiovascular systems and a whole host of other problems, physical and psychological. And in many cases, indefinite detention rises to the level of torture. All right? That sounds very clinical and textbook, I know. So let me tell you about some of the men that I have represented. All right, Fauzi Al-Oda. He was brought to Guantanamo in January of 2002. He's a Kuwait citizen. His father is an Air Force colonel with the Kuwait military who fought alongside the U.S. in the first Gulf War. There have been no charges against Fauzi. Obaidullah. That's my former client, Obaidullah. He was picked up when he was 19. He's been there for over a decade. Can you imagine spending a decade of your life away from your family?
Yes.
He had charges against him, but those charges were dismissed, meaning there is no evidence of any crimes that he's committed. Why is he still at Guantanamo? Obaidullah is on hunger strike. And he has been for, as we hear, 141 days. Obaidullah wrote this poem. I'm going to read you an excerpt. It's called Life is for Love. The moon had thousands of complaints. She had wept heartfully. Her tears were shed on the flowers. She was saying that life is for love. There are left but a few days of life. Then why do you hate and oppress and always fight each other? You are wise and privileged. You are the best of all the creatures. Then make prosperous this world by the power of your wisdom. Choose for yourselves and others the laws of humanity. Indeed, where is our humanity? Thank you. There are people all over the country participating in a rolling fast to be in solidarity with the men at Guantanamo who are on hunger strike. And we have with us today Diane Wilson, who's a fourth generation shrimper and environmental activist on the Texas Gulf Coast.
And if I understand correctly, Diane, you're on your 55th day of a water-only hunger strike in solidarity with the Guantanamo hunger strikers.
Thank you very much. I'm real glad to be in the most important spot I think I can be. I'm on a 57th day of a hunger strike. I've lost 46 pounds. I am a little daffy in the head at times, and I forget things, so I like to keep it short, but I am here with you people of conscience for one reason. It's because I think the man behind me, and he might be hiding in the closet right now, but I believe he is the man that can start the release of these detainees now, today, and I believe it is pressure, our pressure, that will make him do it. And I believe a wave is growing, and Obama best look out his window.
Thank you. Thank you, Doug.